So let's send some cops. A year ago, Ning became owner of the house. The home was listed as a gift on his tax return. Because he's fairly high up in the gang, we're going to go ahead and send the SWAT team. And then two of our most competent officers. And everything looks good, okay. Is the day over? And they got him! Awesome. I'm very happy now. We're not going to arrest him yet. Because we want to get to Jin Yang. End the day. Racist gangs run wild in city. Investigation into Francis Kendrick could resume. Oh shit. Second tower to be built in Freeburg. Is this just gonna go straight? I would like it if this would just kind of went straight back into the gameplay, or... Nope.
The people of Freeburg have built up a tolerance for the petty horrors of modern life. You'll never see crowds gathering around a beaten passerby. Folks rarely even slow to gawk at a car accident. And street theft doesn't turn heads anymore. Been a long time since people got worked up about stuff like that. So when I ran into a troubled crowd on the way to work, I knew there was something serious going on. Something bad enough to knock these people out of their daily rhythm. And we're talking about people who would step over a corpse if it was blocking the door to the coffee shop. But apparently all it takes is a bunch of leaflets, or spreading broken glass across Main Street, or releasing a couple of hundred rats in the ice arena. The mysterious figure taking responsibility for these strange acts goes by the alias Robespierre. Nobody knows who he is, what he wants, or what all this adds up to, from the buckets of lard spread on the sidewalk to the front door of City Hall covered with ostrich feathers. But this strange cross between childhood pranks and cheap theatrics has got the people all worked up. Everyone understands when some Freeburg crook satisfies the basic human need to rob and kill. But when someone steals a lion from the local zoo and locks him in a cell below the courthouse, the people start asking questions. Myself, I kinda like this Robespierre. It's not just the pranks he's pulling or his green bull's head emblem. I just like his funny nickname. Robespierre? Really? Who does that make me? The Marquis de Lantenac? I don't think so. In the old books about revolutions, I fancy myself the old gunner who goes off to war with a bag of damp powder. Or maybe the innkeeper who tops up the beer kegs with mop water. It's something to think about.
Alright. Oh, what's... Martinstead is your new deputy. Why do I have a deputy now? I don't want him. My kid's been causing trouble again, and they've called me into his school. Can you give me some time to deal with this? Yes, go ahead. While I was climbing up the stairs, I started feeling dizzy. Can I have the day off? Let's see, I'm gonna say yes, but come in tomorrow. New records can be obtained as a gift or a thank you for your service. But why wait when you can refill your collection now? Ooh, there's a catalog. In the Old Riches List catalog, you can always find a rich assortment at the lowest possible prices. Pre-order and save. So, let's have some Beethoven. And we'll get the others soon. Gotta listen to those. Let's do Beethoven! Yes! Yes! Okay. The Mafia can offer you some very interesting services. You're practically a member of the family now, so it will hardly cost you a thing. Sands. Crime Tap. The Mafia will falsify a special crime in progress report, and all the officers who arrive at the scene will be killed. No, thank you. The Mafia will falsify a special investigation, and the detective who arrives at the scene will be killed, and then threaten. The Mafia will intimidate members of the committee before the hearing at a... Ooh, that one I might use in the future if, like, I have any serious issues. Your new assistant is no Kendrick, but he's not as useless as he might seem. He can handle some of your duties when you're pressed for time, but lunch is on you along with any other expenses. So, police academy, train your staff, send them to a barbecue, hire a snitch, buy silence, convince your employee not to testify against you, consulting a detective, buy names. So some of these will definitely be useful in the future. So, a shoe store clerk reports that two teenagers found the most expensive sneakers on display, tried them on, and then without paying, ran out of the shop wearing the new shoes. So we're gonna send our best and worst. How do I... There we go, start to investigate. Yes! Okay, wait. And then we go... Oh, I can't arrest him now. That sucks. Oh, what's this? This woman was an honest servant of the city. Today she is buried with military honors. The investigation has started. Oh, damn. The teens are standing around smoking not far from the store, admiring their new shoes. Time to grab the boys. Yes! Okay. A man returned from work earlier than usual and found his young wife in bed with her lover. The maid called the police when she saw the husband... Oh, taking the hunting rifle from the wall cabinet. Shit. You don't mess with a jilted husband. Let's see how that turns out, and... Oh. Today in Freeburg, we're hosting the premiere of Back to the Future, the films. Distributors have asked the city for an officer at the door to ensure that visitors don't bring their handheld cameras to the theater. Okay, well, we'll send him. I'm not really concerned about it. Oh, damn! I liked those two. They did good work. I want to hire him. It is shift day. And then also shift day. A young father, deprived of his parental rights, tried to pick up his daughter from school. When he wasn't allowed access, he attacked the teacher, knocked her to the ground, and started kicking her. I think those two will be able to handle it. I'd like to save my best officer for, like, the tricky cases. Alright, what is this? Mr. Boyd, I have a very sensitive issue which a mutual friend Charles Dill said you could help me with. You may already know I own the largest music store in Freeburg. Recently, my ex-wife got half my record collection in a lawsuit. There's a lot of rare records. My ex is very afraid of the police and always tries to act like a law-abiding citizen. If some of you guys went over there in uniform and told her those records were evidence in an important investigation, she'd just smile and give them whatever they asked for. And not even check into the warrant. I know. Sorry, sir. Sorry you have a bitter fucking divorce. I get it. But I'm not helping you cheat your wife out of what she's entitled to. Jack, we have something going down today at engineering plant at 11:09. No, not 11:09, 10:09. 22:09, there we go. We wouldn't want any policemen crashing the party. I think $4,000 would be enough for such a request. It depends on what it is. I'm not entertaining that guy's thing because I'm sorry, but... Oh, what's this? A guard says that someone got in the exhibition hall, scrawled pictures of penises on the artwork, and hid in the closet. This does not require our best guy. Oh, man. I just think that's ridiculous that you're gonna use the police to settle a score with your wife. Find some other way to get your collection back. All the lights are on when the police arrive. The museum caretaker explains that he's only had the job a couple of weeks and he's worried he's going to be fired over this foolishness. The police calm him down and he points out the bathroom stall that the artist locked himself in. Enter the adjoining stall. Come out with your hands up. A terrified and tearful young man holding a knife insists that he's engaged in some kind of performance art and that no one understands him. He refuses to surrender and is threatening to stab himself. Don't worry, you're not in any trouble. We just want to talk. Tell me more about your work. Tell me more about your work. Damn! At least the officer was unharmed. And is that it? Is that it for the day? I think that just... No, this can't be it for the day. We still have a few hours left. But I'm guessing the only thing that's going to come through is that engineering plant that we don't want to necessarily get involved in. Theft. We just received a call from the groundskeeper at a machine factory. He spotted two offenders stealing aluminum from the factory through a hole in the wall. We're in the mafia's pocket, and this is something I can give them, considering that, quite frankly, if they're starting to murder people, no, that's where I draw the line. I'm gonna let them steal a little bit here and there, though. Especially, like, I think... Actually, I don't remember. I don't remember how far I played into this game before. I know we were in the media's pocket for a little while. Ooh! Got 3 new frames. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna go... Nope. Okay, so let's see. Try this. Nope. So then we'll change up the order and go this. Ha! Jin Yang, owner of the Wise Dragon Restaurant. Score! Let's send some officers down. Ooh, and she's the leader. Do we want to send SWAT for support? Why not? I love some drama. Thank you for doing as we asked. Here's the amount we agreed on. And, oh, okay, yeah. Jack. You must have seen the newspaper stories about Thomas Blaine, the retired cop who went schizophrenic and shot a pregnant woman. To ensure this tragedy doesn't repeat itself, we've decided to conduct psychological testing for all cops over 50 years of age. That includes you, Jack. Tomorrow morning, Dr. Eleonora Waterbury is waiting for you in her office. Don't be late. Fine. Fuck you. Come on, I want the leader of the gang. Come on, I want the leader. Yes. Yes! Oop. Eliminate the gang. Yes. Yes. Yes! Ooh! 20,000! Yes! 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 Jack, keep up the good work and we'll make sure your final days in Freeburg PD are much more comfortable. Fuck you, Mayor! Fuck you! I'd do anything just to make your life a bit more difficult, but I like catching the bad guys. I do. Even if I'm one of the bad guys right now. I enjoy it. City Treasury doles out 90,000 for Mayor's birthday. Mysterious Robespierre announces political ambitions. Chinese gang operating under Boyd's nose for years. Fuck you. Fuck you. Alright. I've been playing for 2 hours. I'm gonna take a break. I will see you guys next time, and thank you very much for watching.